If the world in the next few years or two is totally destroyed, or large parts of it, there should be a monument somewhere which somebody would survive to put up, and on it would be inscribed, "Women had very little part in this."
Colonel Montmorency, who was in Calcutta in 92, emerged from his retirement for the war. He wasn't very pleased with all he heard and all he...
I went up to him, and I can hardly repeat what I said, but I've repeated it so often. I gave my salute and said, "Heil Hitler, Sie sind bei der englischen Jugend sehr beliebt." You're very popular with the English youth. A dreadful thing to say. It wasn't true even then.
Could you please oblige us with the Bren gun?
He gave me a copy of Mein Kampf and signed it, and I lost it the same day. It fell through a hole in my car. I found myself hiding in a kind of tool shed, and there was a window, and through the window I could see a collection of Germans standing about, wondering what to do and where to go and what that had happened. And I thought I'd hurl a grenade in the midst of them. And then I thought better of it. I thought it probably hit the bars of the window and bounced back on me. A little bit later, I found myself advancing with the grenade in my hand with the pin out. And the pressure on my hand, the tension was so great, it was holding the pin down. And I threw it into the drink, luckily. Otherwise, there wouldn't be any more me. I put my hands up. I think I did it on purpose. People told me afterwards, "We saw you with your hands up." And I'm never quite sure if I thought afterwards I put my hands up deliberately to show the way it had been a success, or whether it was something I invented afterwards. And then we got into the train and changed onto a small branch line, stopped at the station in the early morning with a wonderful, wonderful view of a snow-white castle, floodlit, just like the castle in the film of Snow White, and that was Colditz. And there I was. When I was about 21, 22, I had an affair with a guy, Burgess, who was a spy. Had my father known, he suspected it when I was quite young, when I was about 20. He summoned me one day to speak to him alone, and he said, "Are you homosexual?" And I didn't know the answer then. And you know what he did? It was his solution to everything. He went to Buckingham Palace, and he got a message for me from Buckingham Palace saying, "They're ready for you." So I had a summons to one of the king's doctors, to see the king's doctor in Buckingham Palace, and I went there, and just after the war, it's really quite funny. He said, "How's your father?" And I said, "You back? And what was it like in prison? And you're looking very well. And I hear you have a bit of a problem." I said, "Yes." And this time he said, "Well, will you undress?" So I undressed, and he thumped a bit and examined my balls and my breasts and so on. He said, "My dear boy, there's nothing wrong with you at all. You're perfectly normal." And I thought, how awful, how scandalous, and what bad luck on the royal family to have such advisers. My publisher wrote in a blurb to one of my books, she was extraordinary by any standard, quite dazzlingly beautiful. She was born in Rio. Mother was a cousin of W.B. and Jackie Yates, so she was Irish. She was extraordinary. And she rescued me from what might have been a very empty life. For a long time, I accepted that I preferred men to women, until I found I could make love to Mary very happily. And I used a phrase which I felt that it was more important, more enriching, to live a life with a woman for me than with a man. And I used the phrase, it's one of the immortal openings into life, is life with a woman. And one thing I have learnt from Mary is that I wish I'd asked her more about herself. I'd never been absolutely sure how much she suffered from the fact that I was so gay, that how much it upset her. Well, she hid it and to tell him that I shouldn't be hurt.
We'll meet again. Don't know where. Don't know when. But I know.
And one of the reasons I like to believe in God is so that I can protect other people when I die. And also to have somebody to thank.
Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know, tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go.